Hi everyone, hope you're doing well. Today we will be continuing the famous YouTuber's free strategy that you all really like. This series and pay strategy series usually take a lot of time because I don't want to rush any strategy and miss out on any points and make the result unfair. I want the result to be as accurate as possible so that you don't have any doubts. But still, if you have doubts or feel like I missed something, you can comment below and I can clarify it. Also, don't worry, I'll be starting the paid series in few times. I'm still figuring out the formatting of the video. So let's continue. Also, before starting the video, I would like to get your feedback. Do you like my content only in English? Yeah, aapko Hindi aur English ka combination chalega. Please comment below and let me know. So YouTubers whose strategy we are going to be testing was controversial for some time recently. Well, I don't personally follow him and don't know what the fuss was all about, but I heard a lot of criticism about this guy. The guy's name is Anish Singh Thakur from Booming Bulls. Before we start, I would like to say something. It's okay to criticize someone. That's your personal right. If you think he's a fraud or something, you are bound to have your opinion, and that's not wrong. But I have seen people sharing images of his wife and personal life on many groups or Telegram channels. I think that's not right, right? You shouldn't involve anyone's family. If the person is wrong, you can criticize him as you want. But please don't give hate to someone's family members. That's all I wanted to say. Let me repeat one thing, I am not on YouTube to create any kind of controversy or drama. I'm just here to test the strategies and help new traders to identify if the strategy is good or just marketing, which in turn helps them in their trading career. And we can build a community where we can share each other our views and strategies and help each other, whether it be a new or old trader. So if you want to join our journey, you can subscribe to us and show your support. Well, today the strategy which we will be testing is VWAP plus pivot plus stochastic RSI strategy, which is one of the most famous strategy in his channel with more than 1.6 million views. One thing is for sure, this guy has a great presentation and advertising skills. That's for sure. For those who are new to indicators, so VWAP indicators are similar to moving averages, but VWAP considers both average prices and volume of the stocks. VWAP is used for strong support and resistance by many traders. You can also see the formula on the screen for VWAP if you like. For pivots, we will be using a Fibonacci pivot. Let's not go deep into it. But for your knowledge, it's similar to regular pivot, but this is created considering Fibonacci series. Formula will be on the screen. And for stochastic RSI, this is an oscillator, which is a combination of stochastic and RSI. Formula for stochastic RSI is displayed on the screen. For more information, I will give the link in the description for all the indicators, so you can study more about it. I think that's enough introduction. So hi everyone, this is Pranit from Trader Insight. Let's start the video. So in this strategy, we will be using the combination of three indicators. Let me show you how to plot all these. First, the time frame will be 5 minutes. Next, we will plot pivot points. Just search pivot point standards and here it is. Now go to settings and select type as Fibonacci. Number of pivot bags, I'll set it as 200. So we will have pivots for last 200 days. Now the next indicator will be VWAP. Settings will be the default one. And lastly, we will add stochastic RSI. Here also the setting will be default one. First rule for trading in this strategy is you should only trade after 10:45, not before that. So no trade before 10:45 a.m. IST. Well, now rules for buy entry. Your buying price or entry price should be just above the pivots, okay? Second condition, buying price should be above the VWAP, and in stochastic RSI, the blue line should be above the orange line. Let me clear it once again. We are not waiting for the candle to close above pivot, okay? We are just waiting for the price to cross above any pivot. At that time, the price should be above VWAP also, and the blue line should be above orange in stochastic RSI. That's our buy entry. So this is our buy entry. Now for stop loss. As per his video, stop loss will be below VWAP and we should not keep tight stop loss. While testing, price crosses VWAP and comes up again and hits our stop loss. So I have modified it a little. I am adding another condition where your stop loss will be the lowest value of VWAP and the low of previous candle. So if low of previous candle is below the VWAP, the stop loss will be below the low of lowest candle. So if low of previous candle is below the VWAP, then the stop loss will be below the low of last candle. Similarly, if VWAP is lower than your low of last candle, your stop loss will be just below VWAP. So I think the stop loss is clear, right? Target will be the next pivot or 0.75%. He mentioned in his video to keep maximum target as 1%. We are keeping it as exactly 0.75%. So if the next pivot point is more than 0.75, we will take our target at 0.75%, and if next pivot is lower than 0.75, we will take the pivot as target. So I think that's also clear, right? Let me show you an example here. We will buy at this candle. Since price crossed above pivot, price is also above VWAP, and the blue line in stochastic RSI is above the orange one. Stop loss will be here below VWAP and low of last candle, and the target will be here, and that's a win, right? Yeah, the only problem here is we don't have a predefined risk reward ratio in this video. Sometimes you can get an amazing risk reward ratio, and sometimes you can get a low risk reward ratio. In few instances, it was less than 1, but since he has not mentioned it in his video, we will not change it. I know many of us are still thinking about taking an entry before the close of candle, but he said it's okay to enter in his video, so I will be testing it in the same way. Similarly for sell condition, you will sell when price crosses any pivot. VWAP should be above the price and stochastic RSI blue line should be below the orange one. Stop loss will be the highest of last candle or VWAP. Target will be the next pivot. So let's see why he is being criticized and how bad the strategy is. So I'll start the forwarding. You can also slow the playback speed in YouTube and check the trades. So the tests are over. As you can see, total number of trade was 100, out of which 62 was win, 38 was loss. Winning percentage was 62%. Total gain in an account was 60.52%. Wait, what? Seriously? Max drawdown is just minus 3.9%. You can also see the equity curve and max drawdown curve. Continuous win in a row was 9 and continuous lose in a row was 4. Test duration is just 1 month. Well, I don't have any words. The results are not what I thought initially. After learning about the first, I was biased and was expecting it to be a short video and would have ended in explaining you to not to fall for this strategy. But these results are something else. Let me clear. I'm not telling you will gain 60% return in this strategy, but from backtesting, it has given these results. You should also do your testing and find the result for yourself. But wow, I'm really impressed by this strategy, which is given by Anish Singh Thakur. I don't know what the fuss was about, but the strategy is pretty solid. 60.52% gain in just 1 month. Kudos to Anish Singh Thakur from Booming Bulls. Guys, I'll add the link of his video in the description so you can understand the strategy better from his channel. I have also added the strategy in the Google Sheet. Link will be in the description. And this takes the top position in the list. You can also check the list and review or rewatch any specific strategy you like. Okay, so let's come to the serious topic right now. From 1st September, there will be no leverage on intraday trading, both in equity and derivatives. you have to keep 100% margin to take trades in intraday. Currently, if you have 10,000 rupees, you could trade up to 50,000 worth of shares. After 1st September, if you have 10,000 rupees, you could only trade off 10,000 rupees only. This will impact both the traders, whether it be intraday or swing traders. For intraday, they won't be able to diversify their trades unless they have a lot of funds. And for swing traders, as there will be no leverage, the brokers will not be able to make money, and therefore they will charge brokerage in delivery trade as well. I think so. Upstock has already started this right now, and similarly other broker might even do it. This will also create a major problem, and one of them is freak trades. Those who are unaware of what's happening, a couple of freak trades were happening on Friday, 20 August, where 37,000 PE of Bank Nifty actually opened at 1 rupees when its previous day's close was above 1400, and then quickly got back to its fair value in a split second. Similarly, many cases happened that day, which completely wiped all the profits or even their entire capital of all the retailers. I feel sorry for those who have lost way more than they could have afforded. The reason for this was low liquidity. If there were enough bid quantity for every ask quantity and vice versa, there definitely won't be such freak trades and spikes unless and until it's clear manipulated by any big hand in the market. So who actually profited from freak trades? The institutions and HFIT firms, obviously, who actually received data quite earlier in millisecond difference, okay, because of their infrastructure and a close proximity to the exchanges, and they can punch order a lot faster. So if no margin rule is applicable, this can potentially make low liquidity scenario even worse and cause even more such freak trades, which eventually lead to unimaginable loss to the retailers. So traders all over India will be peacefully protesting by not trading on September 1 and make the authority understand the seriousness of the matter. Whether it will change something or not, that's supposed to be seen. So I would request everyone to please support this movement and trend hashtag no trade day on all social media and tag SEBI regulators. We can just hope our voices are reached and the disconnect between SEBI and retail traders can be reduced. So guys, if you like the video, please support us by subscribing the channel and hitting the bell notification, and do like the video and share the video. Please give feedback and what other trading strategy that you would like me to cover in the future videos in the comments. Also, you can check out other strategies tested on this channel. All the social media links will be in the description. Please follow us and show your support. More awesome contents are on the way. So see you next time.